Brian G. Johnson here, and on behalf of myself and Nico, we'd like to welcome you to the Morning Fame Keyword Research Tutorial. Let's jump in. First off, Morning Fame is unique in that it measures your channel's authority. This is something that other tools don't do. Really cool. And it also measures what's called relevance opportunity. We'll talk more about that as we move forward. Know this, regardless of using Morning Fame, one of the things that's super important for YouTubers is to go through this four-step process where we begin with a topical idea. I want to make a video about a cake. And then we select a more specific keyword. I want to make a video covering a chocolate mousse cake. And then you're going to select and evaluate a search term to ensure you've got the channel authority, and also there's the relevance opportunity. So notice here, we get a relevance grading of an A. This isn't always the case. Your ability to make good decisions regarding selecting keywords, and then in step four, optimizing for those keywords, properly optimizing, will determine your success. This is what Morning Fame does really well, beginning with step number one. As you begin, you can decide to cover a topic that you've already covered. Super smart, because we've got additional analytical information we can measure to know that it really makes sense to do more of these. Don't undervalue topics that have done well. There's a reason why I cover the algorithm a lot, because statistically speaking, I know I'm more likely to publish a video that not only drives views, but gets subscribers. However, and this is something that other tools don't do, Morning Fame is gonna gather information, topical ideas from other channels in your niche. Here you can see we've got Think Media, Video Influencers, there's Casey Neistat, there's video creators, and so on. Pay attention to where you're showing up in suggested videos. It's not easy to get into suggested videos, but over time, if you keep publishing, you keep striving to publish videos that adopt best practices, you will get there. And then know where you're showing up and suggested. I'm more likely to show up on Tim's video creators than Nick Nimmin's channel. So it makes sense for me to maybe get inspired by one of the topics that Tim has covered, and I can do that by, you know, studying the videos here. Let's say I want to cover something like 5 overlooked ways to get more views. So I'll click that now, and we're brought to the step 2 tab. Remember, that's really choosing a target search term. Notice we've got common and uncommon keywords. There's no hard or fast rules regarding which one makes the most sense. What you do want to pay attention to is these results that contain an X. Do not select a keyword phrase that contains an X. We get results back from YouTube. We've kind of got to show all of them. It's not really possible to sort them. But what we can do is provide an X, which means we're not really sure that there's enough keyword volume associated with these keyword phrases to warrant you sticking this entire keyword in the title of your video. That's the goal. Remember, we're going to optimize for a specific target search term. To do that, you want to include the entire keyword phrase in your video title. So this example, how to get more YouTube views in less time, it's not a good selection. Keyword not found in the search suggestions. Don't target it. So what I would do is I would look for something that's maybe 3 or 4 words long. And the reason why is because as we, again, optimize, we're going to want to add a few other words to our video titles, not only to show up in an SEO fashion where we're doing a good job including the keyword phrase, but we're going to want to add some elements that make it compelling. That takes even more words. So something like increase YouTube views, three words, really smart. How to get views on YouTube, that might be smart too. So these are some of the phrases that I would typically target. Let's click here. You can see that this keyword phrase has been validated. It makes sense for us to move forward. I'll select step number three. This is the heart of what makes Morning Fame tick, because you get to this point and now you get to evaluate and make sure it makes sense for your channel to target this particular keyword phrase. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna measure how well these videos are optimized for this keyword phrase, okay? And what I'm seeing is, I'm seeing some videos where they're bolded. The titles are bolded, how to get views on YouTube. And the reason why is those bolded parts of the title contain this exact keyword phrase. That is the goal. That is what you wanna do. You select a keyword phrase and you're gonna add it to your title. So what we wanna do at Morning Fame is we wanna present you where there are videos that are ranking, but they're not that well optimized for this keyword phrase. And you can see here, this is kind of like in the middle. It's a C, it's not terrible, it's not a D. There's some opportunity, but not much. What if we look at another keyword phrase? Because quite honestly, especially if I've got a newer YouTube channel, if I'm trying to get it off the ground, I'm never gonna target a keyword phrase with relevance below a B. In fact, honestly, I'm gonna go for an A. Let's take a look at something. Remember that other phrase that we saw, increase YouTube views? Notice the relevance, think opportunity, is an A. The reason being is that few of these videos have done a really good job at optimizing their videos for relevance. And this particular video is what's called the gateway video. We'll talk about that more in a minute. Notice that very few of the videos ranking have that exact phrase in yellow. Sunny's done a good job to include increased YouTube views. That was absolutely by design. She's a smart gal. She saw that and she included it in her description. This particular YouTuber included it in his video title, which is even more powerful, right? And if we scroll down, you'll see my video has included the phrase two again in the title, and I bolded the word increase so it really pops and stands out. And furthermore, notice I included it in the description. So because most of these video results have poor optimization, that gives us a lot of opportunity and we get an A. Now, about the gateway video. The gateway video has the lowest metrics when we measure across the board for subscribers, views, likes, and comments. So what we want to do is we want to identify a keyword phrase where we have at least a D for subscribers, views, likes, and comments. So we're almost there with the relevance. We've got an A there. Let's see if we look for something like this, if we can improve the metrics. Now you can see here, we've achieved the D across the board, like I mentioned, and furthermore, the relevance is still an A. And furthermore, I'm still gonna have really high relevance for increased YouTube views, and so on. Now, a couple things you can do is you can compare some of the previous search terms, right? So here's our phrase, increase YouTube views. And now you can see when we compare these metrics for these two search terms, increase YouTube views and subscribers versus increase YouTube views, we're doing better with subscribers, views, likes, and comments. The results for the videos in the top 20 results for this keyword phrase are more in alignment for my channel. I've got D's. Now, the search volume is a bit lower, and you really want to only think about search volume in the way of when you compare one keyword phrase in Morning Fame to another keyword phrase in Morning Fame. This has got a bit lower of search volume, but there's something sneaky here. Obviously, like I am still gonna show up for increased YouTube views I'm still going to get that search volume here because this keyword phrase, increase YouTube views, appears in this phrase as well. And this is exactly the process you want to go through as you move forward. Now, what I want to do is move forward to step number 4. However, if you struggle to find a good search term, simply click on this link here. We've got some information that will help you do just that. However, this is a great result for this keyword phrase. I'll click that now. Now, what we want to do is notice the relevance. Remember it said an A, yet I've only got an E. Well, that's because I need to properly fill out my description. And now we've got a C, and furthermore, I need to add some tags that contain this particular keyword phrase. So I'm going to select this. Notice it's got a 7% grading for relevance. This keyword is 7% relevant for this given keyword phrase. So I'll add that, and now we're 77. How about if I add 2018, and now we're at 82%. Let's do this. You increase YouTube views, now we're at 87%. Let's do increase YouTube views 2018. Now we're at 90%. And this is really how you want to tag and write a description for your video. Begin by filling out the tag section. And what you want to do is really select tags that are relevant to your video. And anytime you see an X and a zero, get rid of those because they're not relevant. 2017, and think of it like this. Increase YouTube views and subscribers are the words I want to use in my tags. These are the words I want to see. So fastest isn't in there. It's gone. Fast, channel. I'm going to get rid of all of these. And now we've got 477 characters used out of a possible 500. I'm going to create the same exact phrase, but I'm going to add fast. And now notice the relevance went up to 97% because a lot of the keywords I've incorporated have included the same phrase. Notice this is 10%, the one I just added now. So I'm going to get rid of some of these one word phrases. And now you can see we've got 500 out of 500 characters. I'm good to go. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to write a description that includes these keyword phrases. So as you can see, I've included this tag in the description. Exactly. You can increase YouTube views and subscribers fast by leveraging the strategies taught in this video. So I know that's done, and I'm going to go to the next one. And as you can see, as I include the keyword phrase that's present in the target search term, I'm getting some bolding, which is how it's going to look on YouTube. And that's what we want to see. We want to add this particular phrase to the title, to the description, and to the tags. And now when we've done that, we've got a relevance grading of 97%. Super helpful. When you're done, you can come down to the tag section. You can copy it to your clipboard. And then on YouTube, you can simply paste in the tags from your clipboard and you'll be good to go. So this is the process for using Morning Fame to help you move forward and get better results with YouTube. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.